In this video, I will show you a fast way how to check atrial flutter on ECG. Also, some features of atrial flutter for real ECG nodes I add at the end of the video. So we begin with paper speed and voltage check. Remember, in the case of 25 mm/s paper speed, one large box is 0.2 second and one small box 0.04 second. This is how the same ECG looks in 50 mm/s paper speed, where one large box is 0.1 second and one small box is 0.02 second. The next step is a pacemaker check or examination of the P wave. In our ECG, there are no P waves, which means that this is not sinus rhythm, but instead of P waves, we see sawtooth waves in AVF and V5. The presence of sawtooth waves is a crucial ECG criterion of atrial flutter. Atrial flutter is a macro reentrant atrial tachycardia. Every sawtooth wave indicates one reentry circle inside the right atrium. Atrial activation rate in case of atrial flutter ranges from 250 to 330 beats per minute. Let's calculate the rate of sawtooth waves in our case. For this, measure the distance between them, which is equal to 5 small boxes. For calculation of the rate of sawtooth waves, we use the same formula as for heart rate calculation. The rate of sawtooth waves is 300 beats per minute, which is suitable for atrial flutter. If you like this video, press like and subscribe buttons. We also have Telegram and TikTok. Hit the notification button to check the upcoming videos. So the stadium is the right atrium. The circular track inside the stadium is the reentry circle. And the car is the impulse of atrial flutter. The next step is the regularity check. For this, you need to compare RR intervals to each other. Define the RR intervals as the distances between the peaks of R waves. Rhythm is regular when RR intervals are equal to each other, or the difference between them is less than 10%. In some videos about atrial flutter, you can see information that flutter is regular. But this is not always true, and I explain why. Look at our example. Even by eye, RR intervals are different, and the difference is much more than 10%. So our rhythm is irregular. Irregular rhythm in case of atrial flutter is caused by varying atrioventricular conduction. The AV node cannot conduct every flutter impulse because of its high rate.
Wait, they're all slots?
AV node has a refractory period when it can't conduct any impulses, so some flutter impulses fall inside the refractory period of the AV node. As a result, the ventricular rate is slower than the atrial rate. Let's check the degree of conduction in our case. In V1, we see 4 atrial flutter waves and 1 QRS complex, thus the conduction is 4 to 1. In the next one, 2 flutter waves and 1 QRS complex, conduction 2 to 1, etc. But if the AV conduction is fixed, like in this ECG example with AV conduction 2 to 1, atrial flutter is regular. So the regularity depends on AV conduction, and variability of conduction through the AV node creates irregularity. Now let's calculate the heart rate. For heart rate calculation, you can use any formula depending on the paper speed. Let's use the 6-second rule. For this, define the 6 seconds on the ECG strip. In the case of 25 mm/s paper speed, 6 seconds is equal to 30 large boxes. Now calculate the number of R waves inside the 30 large boxes. After this, multiply the number of R waves by 10. So the heart rate here is 100 beats per minute. But mostly, I prefer other methods of the calculation of the heart rate, which gives us more information. This is the calculation of the heart rate in the smallest RR interval and the largest one. I will use formula 60 divided by RR intervals in seconds. So, minimal RR interval in seconds is 0.44 seconds, and maximal RR interval is 0.8 seconds. Now let's calculate the heart rate for each of them. There are 136 and 75 beats per minute, so the heart rate ranges from 75 to 136 beats per minute, which describes how irregular this rhythm is. The next step should be mean QRS axis calculation, but due to the limitation of three-lead ECG, we can't do this. So the next step is measurements of P, PR, QRS, ST, and T wave. Both P wave and PR interval do not exist due to the absence of the P wave. So we start from the QRS complex. QRS complex is equal to two small boxes or 80 milliseconds, which is in the normal range. ST segment, T wave, QT interval, and corrected QT interval can't be estimated because the sawtooth wave deform ST and T wave. As I promised, one thing for nerd. I don't think the medical students need to know it. This information is mostly for the future cardiologists or just for showing off. Atrial flutter can be typical and atypical. In most cases, atrial flutter is typical. Typical atrial flutter means a macro reentrant circuit in the right atrium, with the impulse rotating clockwise or counterclockwise around the tricuspid annulus, and using the cavitricuspid isthmus as the essential part of the reentry circuit. And we can see this exact impulse movement on ECG. Here we see tricuspid annulus and reentry path. So the first portion of sawtooth wave represents cavitricuspid isthmus, the slowest and crucial part of the circle. The second, red part of sawtooth wave, represents the movement of the impulse through the interatrial septum. The yellow part represents the upper part of the right atrium free wall, and the terminal green part, the lower part of the right atrium free wall. So, if the sawtooth waves are oriented downward in inferior leads, the second, the third AVF, and upward in V1, in this case, impulse of atrial flutter moves around the tricuspid annulus in the counterclockwise direction. If we see the opposite situation, negative sawtooth waves in V1 and positive ones in inferior leads, in this case, the atrial flutter impulse moves in the clockwise direction. If you like the content, press like and subscribe buttons, and have a good day! Here we go.